It is also worth to think about the cable lengths you're choosing. Some sensors have cable lengths of 3 meters and no interconnection. Our Suniri sensor has intentionally a cable length of 1 meter, plus minus, and a USB connection, which is not fixed. That is just done as a poor precaution. In reality, it happens once in a while that somebody pulls the cable or, plainly speaking, falls over the cable. In that case, the USB connector of our sensor comes loose. It should not be done regularly, but it does not cause harm to the system, nor does it add a likelihood of harm to the people which just did fall over the cable. Now imagine another sensor, another design, which we could have done, where the cable is attached fixed to the electronic. In that case, either the cable at the electronic side or the connector at the PC side fails. And you have much more trouble as to reconnect the USB cable which just slipped out of its position. Talking further about that, all of that features which are desired but not typically addressed, this is the question: how long do you decide to make the cable between the sensor and the electronic? So for the Suniri, the Suniri team decided to make it 3 feet. And the Suniri decided to make a detachable connection of the USB cable to the electronic. That has certain benefits. One benefit is you can replace the cable with a commercial cable if needed. And you just have to consider that once in a while, in some operatories, somebody is pulling on the USB cable or falling over it. And the fact that it's detachable is just a built-in breaking point. So in that case, no harm happens, neither to the electronic system nor to the human being falling over the cable. Now, if you would have decided to fix the cable, in such a case, either the cable fixture at the electronic or the connector side at the PC would fail, and it would cause much more damage to equipment as in our case.